All right, just gonna do a video about this recent tragedy at this Travis Scott concert, where I guess some people died, but I think it was like 9 people died at this concert, and it's very, very tragic what happened. And I do happen to believe this was a Jesuit Illuminati blood sacrifice. And you see, oh, you're just getting conspiratorial. Well, I'm gonna show some news articles and some scriptures about this that kind of relate to this subject, and gonna point out about why I believe this was an Illuminati blood sacrifice. And you know, obviously, the Illuminati, I've shown in past videos, the Illuminati has their presence in Hollywood. The Jesuit-ran Illuminati has their presence in Hollywood and the music industry. And just going to cover a few scriptures on the subject, then read some news articles, and just show why I do believe this is an Illuminati blood sacrifice. So first, let's get into the Word of God. 2 Chronicles chapter 33, verse 6. What does the Bible say about sacrificing children by, you know, through fire? What does the Bible say about that? 2 Chronicles chapter 33, verse 6. And he caused the children to pass through the fire in the valley of the son of Hinnom. Also he observed times and used enchantments and used witchcraft and dealt with a familiar spirit and with wizards. He wrought much evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. So causing your children to pass through the fire, child sacrifice essentially, blood sacrifice, causes God to be provoked to anger. And it also goes in with witchcraft and enchantments and familiar spirits. You look at the history of rap rock music and voodoo. Sorry, you look at the history of rap and rock music, it ties back to voodoo, I'll put it that way. It ties back to voodoo. The drum beats is how the voodoo practitioners would conjure up voodoo spirits. So it is occult and satanic in its origin. So it is, that's why I believe, this was an Illuminati blood sacrifice. But more scripture. Jeremiah chapter 7, verses 31 to 32. And they have built the high places of Tophet, which is in the valley of the son of Hinnom, to burn their sons and their daughters in the fire, which I commanded them not, neither came it into my heart. Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that it shall no more be called Tophet, nor the valley of the son of Hinnom, but the valley of slaughter, for they shall bury in Tophet, till there be no place. And one more scripture, Jeremiah chapter 19, verses 3 to 6. And say, hear ye the word of the Lord, O kings of Judah, and inhabitants of Jerusalem. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, behold, I will bring evil upon this place, the which whosoever heareth, his ears shall tingle. Cats meowing. Because they have forsaken me, and have estranged this place, and have burned incense in it unto other gods, whom neither they nor their fathers have known, nor the kings of Judah, and have filled this place with the blood of innocence. They have built also the high places of Baal to burn their sons with fire for burnt offerings unto Baal, which I commanded not, nor spake it, neither came it into my mind. Therefore, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that this place shall no more be called Tophet, nor the valley of the son of Hinnom, but the valley of slaughter. That's what God thinks about child sacrifice. It provokes him to anger. And now I'm going to show some of these news articles about what happened at this concert, because basically, I've already established why I believe it was an Illuminati blood sacrifice, because they hate God, and it was essentially a spit in the face of God. But here are some articles about how this whole thing came about, and just describing the whole event. I'll show the articles. So this is from, what did I just do there? So Travis Scott unruly concert history raises red flags in Astroworld lawsuits. So basically what's happened is that because of this concert tragedy, where these 9 tragic deaths occurred, there's been all these lawsuits that have come, obviously, as a result. And apparently there was these unruly concerts. He had a history of doing these unruly concerts, which, again, you know, the Illuminati obviously would use that to their advantage to do this blood sacrifice to spit in the face of God. Oh, you're just being conspiratorial. Sure, you can call me that all you want, but the truth is the truth, no matter who doesn't like it. Lawsuits are piling up in less than a week after a deadly crowd crush at the Astroworld concert, and legal experts say the risk mounting and that juries could decide what against the rapper Travis Scott and the companies behind the tragic event in Houston. Several legal experts told the Associated Press that Scott's past incitement of concertgoers offers a history that could make it easier to pursue negligence claims against companies that plan and manage the show, which killed 8 people and left hundreds injured. Although the investigations have just begun, experts expect dozens more lawsuits seeking damages that could climb into the hundreds of millions of dollars. See, this is what working for the Illuminati does for you. It costs money, because these rappers and rock artists, they encourage violence and crime and criminal activity in their songs. And again, it ties into the Illuminati Jesuit agenda of order out of chaos, the New World Order, you know, prophesied in Revelation chapter 13, verses 10 to 14. Whole other issue, but I could go into that in a separate video. But this unruly kind of mob mentality that's promoted at rap concerts, it's just part of the Illuminati satanic Jesuit agenda. At the center of a legal maelstrom is Scott, 30-year-old famous rapper who, for whipping fans into a frenzy, who has pleaded guilty to misdemeanor charges, tied to stirring up crowds at previous concerts. Quote, "This puts everyone on notice. This is what happened, and there is no reason it can't happen again," said John Weiner, a lawyer from Barrymount, Texas, who is not involved in the Astro World case. Quote, "They know this is a situation that can get out of hand." Then they go down. More than a dozen lawsuits have been filed so far against Travis, or against Scott, and several companies, including entertainment giant Live Nation, concert promoter Score More, and a nonprofit managing the Houston-owned venue. The complaints allege that the organizers failed to take simple crowd control steps to staff properly and to act on early signs of trouble, and sold-out concert at NRG Park that attracted 50,000 fans. Then they go down there. There's a whole legal mess that came from this foolish rapping concert that led to the deaths of people. It literally, see, this is what rap music does. It kills people. It leaves people dead because it promotes a criminal lifestyle of anarchy and lawlessness. Here's another article from the BBC. Astroworld Travis Scott should have stopped concert earlier, says fire chief. Yeah, exactly. Or maybe just not held the concert at all. Maybe just not sold out his essentially his allegiance to the Illuminati Satanists that run Hollywood and the industry, the music industry, the Jesuit-ran Illuminati Satanists. Continuing. Rapper Travis Scott should have halted the show in Houston, which saw a deadly crowd surge, and when he noticed people in trouble, the city's fire chief says, quote, "Everybody at the event had a responsibility," Samuel Pina told NBC, quote, from the artist on down. Eight people were killed and hundreds more in a crush at his Astroworld concert in Texas on Friday. The artist said he was devastated by the incident and was working to help the victim's family. His partner and businesswoman and media personality Kylie Jenner said they only learned that there were fatalities after the event. Among those injured was a 9-year-old boy who was said to be fighting for his life after he was trampled at the event. Quote, "This young child and his family will face life-altering trauma from this day forward, a reality that nobody expects when they buy concert tickets," quote, a lawyer for the family said in a statement on Tuesday. Police said the victims were crushed in a surge of fans near a stage at around 21:30 local time, which is the military clock time. Scott continued to perform for almost 40 minutes longer, eventually ending the set in about 15 to 20 minutes ahead of the advertised time. In the footage of the concert, he can be seen interrupting his performance to ask for help for a fan who had passed out. But in another video, he asked, "Who asked you to stop? Y'all know what y'all came to do. Chase me, let's go." So he's encouraging this kind of mob, really unruly mentality among his followers. Now let me just go back to the article. Quote, at one point, there was an ambulance that was trying to make its way through the crowd. The artist commanded of that crowd. Mr. Pina, the chief of the Houston Fire Department, told NBC's Today Show. Quote, "The artist, if he notices something's going on, he can certainly pause that performance, turn on the lights, and say, hey, we're not going to continue until this is resolved," he added. Which, you know, is a very reasonable thing. He should have done that, but he didn't. Why? Because his Illuminati Jesuit masters didn't want that, because they wanted their blood sacrifice. Plain and simple. You know, oh, you're just being conspiratorial. Yeah, you can just keep calling me that all you want, really. I don't really care. I've been called all kinds of names. Whatever. Here's actually a picture of the stadium of basically what happened and what was going on there. Basically, it gives you kind of a good view of what was going on. Basically, essentially the stadium of where this all took place, essentially. I'll just put it that way. So then the red is basically where the festival crowd is, and then there's where the crowd surged, and then there's the crowd barriers right there. But all the red is where all the crowd was. So just imagine this big, huge crowd trampling on each other. Pretty lawless and unruly. Just what the Illuminati wants. Order out of chaos. The Luciferian ideology. You know, the Luciferian agenda. Order out of chaos. We'll go back to the article. In an Instagram video following the event, Scott said he was devastated about what had happened and was, quote, sending prayers to the ones that were lost. Yeah. My family's, or sorry, my fans really mean the world to me, he said. Anytime I could make out anything that's going on, I just stop the show and help them to get the help they need. I could never imagine being the severity of the situation, unquote. So that was what he had there. Scott is one of the biggest names in rap music. He launched Astroworld with concert promoters Live Nation in 2018. A bunch of other stuff. So the bottom line is that this was an Illuminati blood sacrifice, a spit in the face of God. And it could have easily been prevented, but there is, you know, obviously, you know, they wanted to have the concert to go on, and Illuminati wanted their blood sacrificed. That's how, you know, bloodthirsty the Jesuits and the Illuminati and the Luciferian satanic secret societies are. It's that simple. So just another example of just the Satanism and Illuminati, Luciferian, Jesuitism that goes on inside the music industry, the Illuminati, Jesuit-controlled music industry. This is why you're supposed to be separate from the world if you're a Christian. Romans chapter 12, verse 2 talks about that. So anyway, just wanted to show you guys that. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all the brethren. Goodbye.